This is a quick review of, not the mouse, an SSD. I'm gonna move this mouse on the side. That's actually RAT7, awesome mouse, but anyway. The cables are stuck, okay. And it's still in a box, so first unboxing. It's a 250 Samsung. You can see the model name. And right, let's open it up and see what's going on. Look at that sticker. Now it's a little bit reflecting, but that's the QR code, the one you can scan, and it should take you to the website. Right. Seem to be having a nice package. Ooh, a CD for a hard drive. That's something new. I wonder why would they have a CD? I mean, it's okay, it's not a hard drive, it's actually a solid state drive. That's what SSD stands for. Looks like I put it the wrong way up, but it doesn't matter. So, and here it is. Wow, this is very light. This is quite tough plastic, so package is quite alright. In delivery it always gets dropped, so that's why the package, I guess, but it's good. Nice red thing on it. It's actually red, it's not really orange as it looks like. Yes, it's completely red, but it looks like it's orange, so it's not actually. Or I don't know, maybe on your screen it is red, so it's actually a red square. Absolutely no idea why would they put it in there. But well, here it is. Nice SSD. It's really, really light compared to the hard drives. Here it is. 250 gigs. Reason why I got this is my primary hard drive have developed a bad sector, and I'm a bit worried about it. Since I'm using TrueCrypt and my hard drive is 100% encrypted, I don't really feel like taking it out and scanning in another computer, so I decided to go for SSD. I'm gonna make an image of my hard drive and hopefully it's gonna go on this one nicely. I'm gonna show you the hard drive slot. Alright, I don't know how good the lights are in there. Let's get some more light in here then. There it is. My computer has a nice slot in front, as you can see. That's for the small hard drive, this slot in here. And that's where it's gonna sit. I can give you a quick preview where it's gonna go. It's gonna just slide in here like that. Don't really want to attach it right now. They say it supports hot swap, but I think I'm gonna turn the computer off. But hell with this, I'll just go for it. And it says that the device is installing. Oh, sorry about the camera. And it says it was successful, so you can't see that right now. Nope, it's not showing up at all. It is not showing up in my hard drives. So anyway, I will work on it and then I will show you some test results, how fast that thing really is. Alright, I have connected the SSD, as you saw in the video. I just had to go through some settings, disable some stuff in Windows and enable the write caching. And now I'm ready for testing. Actually, I did try it before. Now I'm gonna just record the same stuff. And first this one. And this is actually quite slow. This read speed is kinda concerning. Right is, well, about where it should be. I think they are saying that it's rated for 240 megabytes per second, but the reach should be over 500, 540 or something like that, and I really don't know what the issue is. I'm gonna try on this one. As far as I know, this is specifically for SSD drives, this tool. But this one is general, so... But the results are actually the same. This will take a little bit longer. Well, actually, that's faster. It's actually the fastest I've ever got out of it. It used to be stuck around 260. Well, that's about right. Right speed is, well, that's okay. But what's really surprising is I have another hard drive in here. That's an external hard drive. That's a 3 terabyte one. I will show you the speeds on this one. And that is a hard drive. That's a USB 3.0. That's not SSD. And these speeds are kind of surprising. Let's just let it finish and let's see what's happening. Well, that's actually quite slow for this hard drive, but still, that is a hard drive, and hard drive speeds are usually under 100 megabytes per second, so this is like super fast for a hard drive. And let's wait for the write speed to finish. This is actually extremely slow. I don't know what's slowing it down. Don't know if this tool can actually test the hard drive, but it should. I mean, why not? Let's try. Yes, that is a lot slower than it should be right now. This is still a hard drive, not an SSD, so that's quite fast for a hard drive. I have one tool in here, and yes, it is on turbo mode. This is specifically for the motherboard. We'll close this and run another test on this one and see what happens. Before I used to get 210 megabytes per second read and write speeds, so I don't know what might have caused it. Actually, I do know it's the fraps, that's what it is, because my fraps videos are going straight onto that hard drive, and this is why the write speed was slower. So that's normal. But yeah, this is a hard drive and it gets over 200 megabytes per second read and write, which is quite amazing, I have to say, for a hard drive. Yeah, this is about right, because Fraps is recording and it goes straight onto this hard drive. So here are all of my hard drives. And this is where Fraps is recording, so that's why it's slower. But still, these are still quite amazing, considering that the Fraps is recording. It's USB 3, but what I don't understand is how hard drive can be that fast compared to an SSD. So to say about this review, I don't think this SSD is that impressive, actually. There is something wrong with the read speed, definitely, but I don't know what it is. I will run some tests and do some researching, and hopefully I will find out what is causing that slow read speed on the SSD. I have already tried all these Windows things, what they recommend, but I don't know if it would work. There is also something called Ready Boost, which I have absolutely no idea what that does. Obviously it's disabled, so can't even see such service. So probably, I don't know, maybe I took it out before I installed the Windows. However, another problem what might be the cause is that my motherboard has only SATA 2 and not the SATA 3. SATA 2 speed is about 300 megabytes per second, 350 maybe. So it might be the problem, because you never get the actual speed out of anything. Even if the hard drive says that it's 300, you usually end up getting under it. So it might be the length of the cable and stuff, but I don't know absolutely at this point. I just think it's the motherboard. It is getting quite close, I mean, but still, never know. Just run the last test and see. No, it's about the same. It doesn't really change anything. SSDs are quite stable. Yeah, it's a little bit faster now, but still. Well, the write speed is quite okay, but I actually think that the read speed is really getting stuck behind the SATA 2, so. But I might be able to test it in another computer and hopefully find out what's happening. If it's working faster in there or not, so then I will know for sure. I will add updates into description or something, so you can check it from there.